Well, it was an experience that really played out like a movie script, to be honest. It seemed to escalate without warning and with quite a bit of volatility in terms of the nature of how it would change. But we walked into Harare Central Police Station with my lawyer, and I went in there at the behest of the police. And when we went in, they had not said I was being arrested. They said, "We are asking you to come in for questioning." So after the questioning was done, which took maybe an hour and a half, almost two, I was then charged and arrested. And so again, that was a shock. I thought, oh my gosh, I've come for questioning, now I've been arrested. And you know, the charge was inciting public violence. What was going on in the courthouse as I waited in the back was unprecedented. I could hear people singing, they were worshiping, sang worship songs. And at one point, I was praying in the back, and they started to sing a very popular song in Zimbabwe, which called "In Zimbabwe Must Be Safe." And it moved me to tears. I cried in the back. Eventually was called in again for what would be the final statement by the magistrate. And of course, he declared that the arrest had been unlawful and that I was to be released straight away. Ecstatic moment. I was completely happy, but I was so afraid of immediate rearrest. We went back down with the prison officers, and we processed all my papers, and you know, was released outside and met a crowd of people that I was flabbergasted to see. I literally had no expectation that many people were there waiting. So that was it. I mean, it was quite a moment. In fact, I think for about 20, almost 30 minutes, this crowd just overwhelmed me and almost carried me away. I don't even know where they were going with me until we were able to, you know, get the situation under control. So that's how that played out.